Good day and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, welcome. I am Lizanne, and if you are not new, welcome back. So in today's video, I will be discussing, can you be honest with God? Can you? And what I mean by that is sometimes we face disappointment. We come across unanswered prayers. We things in our lives happen and you're just not happy about it. And like this one example, auntie once, someone close to my heart, once said, you must be honest with God. We have been taught wrong as children. For example, you would fall and your knee would scratch. And it's sore. You are hurting. And then they would, no, don't cry, don't cry. It's not sore. Don't cry, don't cry. Like, hello, I just got hurt. I need to cry. That's how I'm going to get through it. And we've kind of grown up with that, where you suppress your feelings and you go on with your life. Okay, so let's dive into the first point. The first point is, if you're not going to be honest with him, then with who are you going to? And it's not necessarily always about deepest, darkest secrets. Fun. Life is not so shallow that it's always going to be about deep, dark secrets. Like, hello, this is life. You just need to, like, for example, I'm a private person. I don't go around saying anything to anybody. So who am I going to speak to? Who am I going to confide in? Where am I going to offload? By the Lord. And I can't be speaking to God and still holding back, because I want to offload. I want to get rid of those burdened feelings and all those, you know? So, yes, you should. You should. It doesn't always come naturally, because you will find yourself praying in circles, you know? Sometimes we pray in circles. Maybe we don't want to ask too much from the Lord of, "Ay, Lord, it's me again," you know? "Again, Lord." And that's okay. That's just our carnal minds coming in and trying to get us away from the presence of the Lord. So don't feel like, "Oh, Lord, it's me again." Yes, 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 the Lord wants it to be you again and again and again and again. And if you be specific with the Lord, we like to speak about, make specific prayers and chutar sozai. Do it. Actually do it. Tell the Lord, "Lord, I need a red jersey. I need a red jersey, Lord." That might sound a bit mediocre. People don't pray about things like that. But let's just make the example. You need a red jersey. Tell the Lord. Tell him this is why. Tell him how it's going to make you feel. I'm sure he knows. Obviously he knows. He's the all-knowing God. But you need to get that off. You need to unload. And that is why you need to be honest with him. Point number two. If you're not going to be honest with the Lord, with who are you going to be honest? Who are you going to offload to? I keep speaking about offload, offload, offload. Like we have like burdens on our shoulders. But sometimes you just need to get something off your chest. And if you're not going to tell someone about it, they're going to make something that there's not, that there shouldn't have been. But if you just took it to the Lord, as neraso, and as ur, and he gives you peace, hachani, finish and klaar. So if, try to refrain. Yes, we do have close friend circles, and if you've got a husband or a wife or someone you can speak to, yes, very nice. But there are just certain things that need to understand. Only the Lord can help you with that. And with those things, take it to him. He will be glad you brought it. If you don't make him your main point, your focal point, your be all and end all, you're gonna drift away from him, because you're gonna seek other things, other people to kind of take your problems to. And if that's how you approach things, then you're gonna drift away from him, because of the main point is ons wil na. We wanna be close to God, you know. We don't wanna be far from him, because he's our God. And we love him. And that is where we belong. We belong at his feet. But, like, say for example, a normal relationship. You want to be with. That's why when you get married, you love together. You can't get married and love separate. It's just not going to work. So why would you want to be far from your God, your maker, your creator, your alles? You know, why would you want to be far away from him? Doesn't make sense. So if he's not your first stop, if he's not your one-stop shop, not shop, but anyway, you can wegdrift, man. Then things are going to start looking appealing in the world and just going to go down the road that you don't want to be down, okay? Trust his will is perfect. Knowing is not enough. And what I mean by that is, you must trust his will is perfect. Yes, you know. We all know. The will of the Lord is perfect. Ma, to know something is all right. But trusting. Now that's a whole different story. If you trust that, even if things are not going the way you want it, the way you've planned it, and you've been waiting and waiting, if you're trusting that God's plan is the best plan, and all things work together for good to them that love God and are called according to his purpose, if that's what you believe, if that's what you hold on to, even if you go through the toughest of times, you will not lose heart. You will not lose faith. You will not drift away from him. Because you know, it doesn't matter what happens. Even if it's not aligned to my plan. Even if it's not aligned with how I picture things and how I want things. This is God's plan for my life. This is the way he wants it to go. And if his plan deviates from my plan, it's all right. His ways is obviously not my ways. My thoughts is not his thoughts, you know. So it's alright. If this video helped you, give it a thumbs up. And even if it just made you think, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't yet, please subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you know when I post a new video. Thanks for watching.